what are we doing?
Helen's school had an art competition.
And the town library's putting the winning drawings up in the lobby.
So Helen wants to stop by the library on the way to school.
I want to see if I won.
Whoa, I bet you did. Oh, can I come too? I want to see.
All right. Don't be sad, sweetie. I'm sure your drawing was terrific.
You're just saying that because you're my mom.
No, she's not. You're a wonderful artist.
You're just saying that because you're my dog. Bye.
See you later, sweetie. I can't stand seeing Helen so sad.
Me neither.
Do you know what I'm going to do? I am going to bake her a cake. That will cheer her up.
I'm feeling a little blue myself. I think I might need a cake, too.
How about if I let you lick the mixing bowls?
Good enough!
Hello? Uh-huh. Yes. Assolutamente. Mrs. Simmons just doubled the number of floral arrangements for her dinner party.
Hey, that's great!
No, it's terrible. I won't get out of here in time to bake Helen's cake.
You hear that, Skits? This is horrible! It's tragic! Because if Mom can't bake a cake, then Helen won't be cheered up, and we won't get to lick the mixing bowls. There's only one thing to do. We've got to bake that cake ourselves. Come on, Skits.
I just had an idea. I'll have the bakery make a cake. Okay, Martha? Martha?
I know just the kind of cake I want to bake. I saw it in a movie once. Close your eyes, and you'll get a big surprise. No peeking. Okay, Skits, wheel her in. Okay, you can open your eyes now.
Yay! Wow, yay! That's the biggest cake I've ever seen in my life.
What will we do with the leftovers?
Mwah. Come on, Skits, let's get cooking. Oh, I forgot. To bake a cake, you need a recipe. A recipe. It's like directions for making food. It gives you a list of things you need to make something and tells you what to put in and when. Hey! A recipe! Good boy, Skits!
Hey, now if only I could read it. Rats.
I know! Thank goodness Helen has this Cooking with Kids DVD.
Hola, kids!
Hola!
Today, we're going to bake a cake from scratch.
From scratch? You mean we just scratch and a cake shows up?
And when I say from scratch, I don't mean you just scratch and a cake shows up.
Oh.
From scratch means making something yourself, instead of buying it at a store. Now, before we start, let's make sure we have all our ingredients.
Ingredients?
Yes, ingredients. Ingredients are things you need to make something.
Like the ingredients for mud are water and dirt. And the ingredients for cinnamon toast are cinnamon and toast. And the ingredients for cinnamon mud toast are water and dirt and cinnamon and toast. Oh, all that talk about mud toast made me hungry.
For our cake recipe, you'll need...
Okay, the first three ingredients are eggs, milk, and butter.
How do we get that open?
Way to go, Skits!
Rats.
Good boy, Skits!
Careful, careful! Now, put the eggs down.
May we borrow two eggs, please?
Almost there.
Hey!
Oh, bummer.
Thank goodness Mrs. Parkington had two more eggs. Hi!
You'll have the cake ready by three? Excelente.
I'll call my dog and tell her to pick it up.
Huh? cup of milk? What will you ask for next? Flour?
Well, now that you mention it.
You're sure these are all the ingredients you need?
Positive. I memorized the recipe. 3 cups of flour, 1.5 cups of sugar, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 3/4 teaspoon of salt, 2 teaspoons of vanilla, 1 cup of milk, 2 sticks of butter, 2 eggs, and 2 greased cake pans.
I'll do it. You'll just spill it. And I'm all out of eggs.
That's odd. My dog isn't answering the phone. Oh.
Combine the flour, baking powder, and salt in a mixing bowl. That's right. Pour them in and stir well.
Mixing bowls? How are we gonna get mixing bowls out of the cupboards? Okay, we're supposed to pour all the dry ingredients, except the sugar, into a bowl and stir. I think this one's sugar. Just making sure. I'll pour the flour. If only I had thumbs. Let's just mix them here. Then we'll scratch them back into a bowl.
Now that we've combined our dry ingredients, let's put them aside. In a separate bowl, blend the butter in with the sugar.
Why she uses a spoon. It's much easier to blend with your paws.
I'm so sorry, Mrs. Parkington. I'll have Danny pick up butter, eggs, and milk on his way home from work. No, it's no trouble at all. He has to stop at the bakery anyway.
Very well, but see that she doesn't make a habit of it. If I know Mad Dog was going to be coming over at all hours asking for groceries, ghost or no ghost, I'd have stayed at my great Aunt Martha's.
What on earth is Martha doing with butter? I'd better finish this order and get home.
Looking good!
Now, beat the eggs.
Beat the eggs? Gee, I feel bad about hitting them.
And I don't mean beat as in hitting something. I mean the kind of beat where you stir something quickly, like this. See how I'm beating them?
I'll try.
Oh, and be careful not to drop any shell into the batter.
Huh?
You should break the eggs like this.
Uh-oh. I like it. Makes it crunchy.
Now, pour the dry ingredients into the butter mixture and stir thoroughly. Then, pour your batter into your cake pan.
Oh, again with the pouring. I can't pour. I don't have thumbs. Hey, let's just dump everything onto the floor, mix it there, and then scratch it into the cake pans.
Yes, dear. I'm heading to the bakery right now. Why is Martha borrowing groceries from the neighbors?
And I was worried I couldn't cook.
Turn on the oven, set the temperature at 350 degrees, and bake for 30 minutes.
Turn on the oven? Turn on the oven? Dogs can't turn on ovens!
Howie! Howie! Wait up!
Thanks for helping us out, Howie.
Happy to help, Martha.
Now, we wait 30 minutes, and then we take the cake out.
Rubber?
Actually... no, I don't know how long 30 minutes is.
But we've got a bigger problem than that. I can't open the oven.
Hey, I've got an idea. And you can absolutely guarantee delivery in 30 minutes? In that case, I'd like a pizza delivery, please. Gee, thanks, Pete. Oh, and just put the pizza on our bill.
Never seen a dog bake before.
Oh, it's Helen! She's here!
What's that smell?
Someone's been baking!
Surprise! We baked you a cake, Helen! From scratch!
A cake?
From scratch?
To cheer Helen up! Go on, Helen! Try it!
Oh, Martha! I can't eat this. It's...
Too special to eat.
That's right. It's too special.
But you have to. It's a cheer-you-up cake. How can you get cheered up if you don't eat it?
But I am cheered up. I don't think I could get any more cheery. This is the best present ever.
Who wants cake?
Silly me. I didn't know my dog talked and baked, so I had Dad pick up a cake.
How about if I eat Dad's cake and keep yours forever and ever?
Well, it's a waste of cake if you ask me.
I have a better idea.
Delicious, if I do say so myself.
Come on, Jakey. I've got to get you cleaned up and ready for bed.
Uh-oh.
My rug!
You have to crack a few eggs to bake a cake.
Look, Grimble's is giving out free samples. Let's get some.
You won't like it.
How do you know?
It isn't food.
Oh, bummer.
Want a spritz?
What is it?
From the way they're spritzing, I think it's perfume.
Perfume?
Blech.
Why do people wear that stuff?
They like to smell good.
If people really wanted to smell good, they'd roll in bacon. I don't think it smells good at all.
Ugh, neither do I. It smells like dog.
Ooh! Looks like it's bath time again.
What? I just had one last month. There ought to be some way around bathing.
Oh, hey! That's it!
Ugh, your dogs are stinkerific. You should give them a bath.
Martha and Skits don't get baths. We just use this perfume. One spritz and they both smell great.
Light, fresh, with a hint of bacon. I like it.
Hey, you're back!
Follow me! If this works, I'll never have to bathe again!
You want my dad to invent a dog perfume?
Yeah, one that's really strong, so I'll never have to take a bath again!
Can't be done.
Why not?
Perfume stinks. Put stinky perfume on a stinky dog and pee. Stink overload.
There's gotta be a way.
No, I think Martha's onto something.
I am? I mean, you bet I am.
Ecologically speaking, think how much water would be saved if dogs didn't bathe. This has enormous implications for the planet.
See? I'm not even thinking of me. I'm thinking of the planet.
I'd be happy to concoct a perfume for you.
The sooner the better.
Concocting sounds hard. Why don't you just make one instead?
I am. Concoct means to make something by mixing different things together.
Oh, are you concocting my perfume right now?
No, I'm concocting my lunch. Pea soup. Want some?
Ew.
Very interesting. According to this book, perfumes have five fragrance families. Floral, which means it smells like flowers. Citrus, which means it smells citrusy, like a lemon or an orange. Woodsy.
Timber!
Ow.
Green, which means it's fresh, like grass or herbs.
You need a trim.
Or spicy. Like pepper or cinnamon.
Water. Water.
That's not what I meant. Is there a bacon fragrance family?
No.
Can you concoct one?
You might be onto something, my canine companion. I'll have to ponder that. But first things first, T.D. Helen!
What are we doing? We should be in the lab concocting perfume.
We have to find the ingredients first.
Perfume has ingredients?
Uh-huh. To make perfume, you don't just use one smell. You combine several different smells.
Combine? Does that mean you mix things together?
Yeah. Ew! Whatever smells we do combine will have to be really strong to cover this up. Smell!
That's okay. I believe you.
No! Really, you have to smell this.
No! T.D.! Eh. Thanks. Do you like the floral smell?
Meh. But that... flippin' fajitas, that smells good!
Martha, garbage is not perfume.
Says who?
Says everybody but dogs.
Aw, great. Now I have to take a bath.
Sorry about that, T.D. Once your dad makes my perfume, you can use it too.
No, really. It's been 9 months, 3 weeks, 6 days, 19 hours, and 34 minutes since I've had a bath. You'd never know it, would you? What are we standing around here for? Let's get those ingredients. Think Martha will like the smell of this grass?
I don't know. She tends to eat it, not smell it.
You guys, come quick. I found the perfect ingredient for my perfume. It's strong, it's fresh, and it has real sticking power. Woo, what an aroma. Bewitching, isn't it?
Martha, we can't put that in a perfume.
Hmm? Why not?
Because we're trying to make you smell better, not worse.
Sorry about that, T.D.
Like any of these?
You're okay. But this shoe! Divine!
This is hopeless! Your dog's idea of a great perfume is garbage, foot stink, and swampy fish goo.
Fish goo. Are you concocting now?
Nope. Now that we have the ingredients, we have to separate them.
Separate? You mean split them up into different groups?
Uh-huh. Separating is like sorting.
Why are you separating the ingredients? I thought you had to combine them to make perfume.
Quite right, my furry friend. But before combining, we extract. And before we extract, we separate.
Extract? You're going to extract? I love to extract!
Ouch!
How do you extract?
Extract means to pull something out of something else. Like I just extracted this burr from your foot.
And I just extracted a potato chip from Helen's plate.
With perfume, you extract scents from different things in different ways. Wood is tough, so you use alcohol to extract its scent. But herbs and grasses are more fragile. You extract their fragrances by steaming them. These bottles each contain a separate extract. We'll combine them to create the perfect fragrance. But beware, not all fragrances smell good together. Some scents, when blended, really stink.
Ugh! A drop holds a lot of smell.
You're telling me.
Where are you going?
To take another bath.
A drop of something.
Why don't you spray your own arm?
Because yours already stinks.
Add a drop of lavender and 2 drops of clove. Too much. Not enough.
T.D., you can't give up. It's no use. You guys have sprayed me so much, my nose can't keep things separate anymore. I'm one big cloud of stink.
I'm not giving up.
Helen, are you crazy? How can you keep going?
Smell her. She sleeps in my room. If I don't come up with a perfume soon, my nose is gonna fall off of my face.
Okay. Woo! This perfume is getting to me.
Getting to you?
Achoo! Stop spraying me!
I got it! The missing ingredient! One drop of this, and we'll have our perfume.
I don't think anyone sprayed me there yet.
Okay, Martha. What do you think?
Ooh, yes, yes!
What's in there?
Extract of bacon. Imperceptible to humans, but to a dog's highly sensitive nose.
Wow, wow!
Precisely.
But is it strong enough to cover dog stink?
There's only one way to find out. Come here and get a spritz.
I don't believe it.
It worked!
No more dog stink!
Oh, gee, on behalf of dogs everywhere, I thank you.
Quick, Helen, give me a bath!
What?
It's the bacon. It's driving the other dogs wild.
Tell your dad thanks for trying to help us out.
Sure.
What?
That perfume. It's in my nose. Everything tastes like bacon.
Bacon-flavored yogurt.
Yum! Want to go to my house and watch Courageous Collie Carlo?
Sure!
Mmm!
Just let me get Martha's perfume. Oh, no!
Maybe it smells different on people.
Told you that bacon would be a big hit.